Imagine if Notion had a powerful AI feature to ask questions to your knowledge base. Well, this is where an application we're going to review today called Slite really benefits. And we're going to unpack some of the more document-based features for knowledge base management for teams that this application has. This is an app called Slite, and we're reviewing it in today's video. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesco. I'm going to take you through Slite today, which is a team knowledge management application. And it's really designed for teams that are looking for coordination of documents. And this might come in the space of being able to organize lighter-based projects, but also being able to manage things like onboarding, things like team information, brand guidelines, and much, much more. We're going to overview what this app does, how it works a little bit more, and give you an idea on pricing and whether this is valuable for teams that are looking for a Notion alternative that might be out there. We're gonna unpack this video in a few sections so you can use the chapters if you do want to skip ahead. But I always like to start with pricing. I think it's a really good important point that helps you determine whether this application is right for you. So here we are with the pricing, and I've gone to the monthly pricing. This application has a free plan, which includes 50 documents, questions and answers, unlimited members, AI editor in the blocks, and also unlimited integrations. But it does have a pro plan, a standard plan it's called, and the premium plan with unlimited documents, unlimited question and answers, advanced doc permissions, read-only doc permissions, and some more advanced stuff with the AI and SSO. But there's also a premium that does include OpenID, SSOs, and user provisioning, as well as support priority and audit logging at $15. $10 per user per month isn't unreasonable for this sort of application. It's much more common to be charged roughly between $8 to $12 for a document management application. So the pricing seems good in the middle basis. And with the AI features, I think it does take a little bit further. So here is what Slite looks like. And it's, first of all, a really nice design. This application has some fantastic onboarding that will help you get started with some of the documentation as well as templates so that you don't have to do that hideous amount of setup. And as a premise, this application wants you to manage your knowledge as a team. So it's trying to reduce things like trapped silo information in Slack and has a bunch of integrations that do help with that. But as a premise, it does go a little bit more structured than applications like Notion, because what it does really well is things like question and answer and wiki-based structures, which Notion has recently released, but Slite has had it much longer and has, in my opinion, does it slightly better. So here we are on one of the pages, and you can create everything with a new document. So in this case, I've created a channel. Channels are basically spaces, workspaces, and you can see here I can start writing straight away. And I can use some of the formatting options like bullet points, checklists, I can even make drafts as well as tables, and I can go into more detail with, for example, databases too. Now, I can go down here and also insert dates. I can also go to set up things like directories, doc cards, and these are all micro templates, a little bit like we have in Notion for some of the components you're adding in here. And as you can see here, you can also create table and board view, as well as a new question and new document. You can also embed a range of applications as well, and there's unlimited integrations in the free plan as well. So let's go into brand guidelines, one that is being created earlier, and you can start to see how this account is going to look. You can personalize it with images, create these pages within pages. So here I went and edited in the tone. You can modify the layout by adding a cover photo, modifying whether it has a table of contents, etc. And you can go back and forth using the breadcrumbs here. Now each page has comments, so you can add comments, but you can also add something called a question. Now it's a little bit different because it's not just you're posting a comment or a question in the doc, you're actually posting it extensively to the question and answers area. So let's say I have a new question and I want to add something like, what should, will you discuss? So the question could be, what's the best place to eat near the office? Obviously, so totally unrelated to work. But in this case, I can add other participants. For example, I don't have anyone, but I could add some other people, and I can even set a due date too. Now, I don't necessarily have to add any ideas here, but I'm going to go ahead and create this. Now, this is a great place because it will pop up in questions and answers, and that's slightly different to, for example, when you've created a comment, because a comment can quickly be dissolved and disappeared inside of the account. Now, comments will live in the same place, but finding them is a difficult thing. So what is quite nice as well is with this question and answer, you can see anything that's currently open. So you can go in and actually see what's being discussed and who's posted in here. But you can also see resolved ones, so ones that have been done in the past, which is really helpful. You can also see ones you own, participate in, or all, or go into a specific document that has questions and answers. And this is really nice because you can constantly refer back to it, which will help you to build this really extensive place. And you can go to the document that actually belongs in, which is really nice. So here is the question that it actually originates from, and I can go back to it, which is great, and open it up, and I can even resolve it if I do find that I've actually fixed that one. So this is something that's not too common in these type of applications, but actually lives in other apps, like I believe Tetra has this, but it's a really nice feature because it centralizes your communications around a question and an answer. The next feature is really locked under Pro, but it's called Knowledge Management. And here you'll be able to see all of the documents that you've created and really narrow them down by all channels, last month, owned, etc. But this will give you more insights into who are the top writers, who are the top readers. And each page inside of the account gets something called verification. And this is something that we've seen in Notion, but we've seen in other applications that essentially gives your team the ability to say, this is the most refreshed version of it. And you can also flag it as outdated, and you can even note as well as verify it for a certain period of time. This is a really good practice if you're in a team to make sure knowledge is up to date. And once that verification is completely gone and you are part of the administration team to sort out or onboarding or support or whatever you do to keep your team's knowledge up to date, then you can keep that flagged so that it's always up to date and fresh. So you can see more insights from here, and obviously that's locked under the Pro plan, or standard plan as they call it, but it gives you a better idea of this experience. Now, I sort of skipped past templates, but a template you can go ahead and create from scratch. Now, there are a range of Slite templates, like for example, if I wanted a design critique, I could see how that looks and I can start using it. So in this case, let's see what a design critique looks like. I can go to use, and I can add it into, say, marketing, into a certain channel, like, say, projects that I might have. Now, you can start to add information, like some of the pre-filled information, so you could add, like, today's date and add it there, and that's great for being able to flag when something pops up, and that'll pop up here, and that's great for being able to find stuff, and you can, as I said, hook up the Slack channel to it as well. You can add attendees. You can start writing out this agenda and all the feedback in here. Now the tasks appear here as well. And of course, if they're assigned to you, you'll get sort of a knowledge of them in the abilities to go into notifications, and you can see that there. So what's really nice about this application as well is you can import from other popular applications like Notion, Confluence, Quip, which is a Salesforce application, and Evernote as well. And that gets you started if you've already got a base on other applications. Now, other elements of this is more around the AI that I would say go a little bit further. Before we do go into the AI stuff, there is updates where it gives you an idea of any new comments, questions and answers and things that pop up in your timeline. You can search across all of your account in this really nice view here. And inside pages, you can go into quite a high level of detail. See history, see insights, follow updates. Protect editing is locked under the standard account, but naturally that does lock each page that you do create. You can save this to the templates, automate the sub-documents so that it sets up automatically. And that basically means if you're reproducing a page, it will automatically help you do that, as well as some other stuff about exporting, copying, archiving, deleting. But it's a really nice structure, and it's quite easy to use when you're actually typing stuff away. Like for example, if I wanted to summarize that document using AI, I could start doing that straight away. If I want to slash command and use some of the table abilities, this is really, really nice. Now, before we actually move on, one of the important abilities in it is actually being able to create tables. And you can, for example, hook up a table that is associated to projects. So in this case, I've got a table that allows me to see all the projects I'm part of, and I can modify whether it's a board or a table and see the owner, sizing needs, etc. Now, let's be clear, this isn't going to be the databases that Notion offer. That is way more advanced, I would say. But in terms of like generalized use, this is nice. Like, it's basic, but it's nice. It gives you the premise of boards and tasks and tables, sorry. But it gives you an idea of how things work. And you can create new views for certain team members, and you can still use this page like you would below it and embed them on that page. So it's really a basic version of databases, but it gives you that insight that you and your team will need. It's not going to be doing a hideous amount of stuff. In terms of a project management system, this probably isn't your project management system, but it's your knowledge management system. And it does connect with other apps with integrations like Asana, Airtable, and many, many more. So I don't think they want to be that. So that's what it looks like with projects. Not a hideous amount, not something they're gonna flag as their main feature, but something that's very helpful just to get you started. So let's show you this AI. Now, this is really cool. So what it does is, this is called Ask. And Ask is developed around asking your knowledge-based questions. So I don't know if you've ever been in a team and you're asking silly questions like, where is the printer stored? And you have that in your knowledge base and you don't want to go and find it. Well, this is like asking a team member where something is. So in this case, I might say, what are principal values for tone of voice in branding? And it basically will scan through what it has inside of the account. So in this case, it's actually picked out this based on what I added, informative and friendly, about what I want the brand values to be. And you can give it a good, the answer is good, so you can help improve it, but you can actually go to the document in this case and find it. So the AI ability here is really nice because it actually takes sometimes a lot of the essence out of it. So that's really helpful. I wonder whether it actually does it for Q&A. I don't know. So I don't know whether this is a cool feature. I'm sure Slite might reach out and say, Francesco, this is a cool feature. But say I was like going back to that office questions, best place to eat near office. I wonder whether it does scan. There we go. It doesn't actually do it. So you can, it does prompt you to give you a teammate to ask a question. I wonder if I filled it in and just put Nando's. Let's see whether Nando's is the correct answer. No. Okay, so I don't know whether I'm doing it wrong or whether it's just something, is something that I do. But it would be nice to have that connection between questions and answers if it does work. So that gave you the basics of Slite. As you can see, this is part of their free plan. So I'm not showcasing the entirety of the features. But if you did want to go a little bit deeper, they do have a standard, a premium plan. And here are the limitations when it comes to attachment sizes. Much, much bigger. 200 megabytes per file and 10 gigabytes per user instead of 2 gigabytes per team. If you're using the free plan, the Ask feature that I just demonstrated has 10 questions per user per month, which isn't bad if you wanted to get started on it. And the AI-powered editor that I demonstrated earlier with like summarizing content and things like that, it's a bit like ChatGPT inside of your communications, then 20 runs per user per month is the limit. But you get unlimited with all of the pro plans, I believe. And then it starts getting more about priority service with premium and more access, I guess. So that's a little bit of an idea of what everything looks like. If you're wanting a bit of an insight into the team activity, you can go here. Integrations can be managed here, and there's a wide range of them, which is really good. Other stuff, you can modify details, see the user groups you set up, and invite members from here. So you can start seeing what the AI functions go like, and you can actually hook up your OpenAI key. So I believe that's actually, so here we go. So once you've got your AI on standard, it actually allows you to hook up your OpenAI key to it, which I believe will be a lot more cost effective than actually using their limitations on their quota. So you can actually set up branding and things like that. Actually, it hooked up my branding quite nicely because I actually just hooked up the regular Google account and it did it pretty well. So you can download their mobile application. This is their Mac app. They do have a web app as well, but if you're looking for more insight on that, you can go to Toolfinder to find out which platforms are available on. That's probably the most up-to-date place to find that as time goes on. Anyway, I've talked for too long. I hope this was a really insightful overview of Slite and it gave you more insight into whether this is an app for you. These sort of applications as a whole, like Tetra, Slab, Slite, all are more document-based management systems. Almanac is another one of them, all really centered around you having documents, not necessarily databases, and having that knowledge more structured. Notion is good, has some good wiki abilities, has some good structure, but not as structured as apps like this, in my opinion. These help you to really structure your knowledge. And with AI-based features like Slite, having, I think it does nip a couple of them in the bud more recently than it does, say, with others. But Almanac has some pretty powerful abilities when it comes to tracking a workflow and modifying processes and changes. Slab, I know, also does question and answer quite well, and so does Tetra. So there's few and far between these. This is the best looking one, in my opinion, if you're really just knocking the differences out of the park. But I'll check out some more of these. If you're interested in checking out more of these, you can jump over on Keep Productive, do subscribe to this channel, and I'm sure we'll cover plenty, plenty more. So thank you very much, and I'll see you all very soon, I'm sure. Cheerio, folks.